The New Jersey Devils have parted ways with GM Ray Shiro. We'll discuss who's taking over and what the future of this club holds coming up next. So welcome back to another video here at Top Shelf Hockey. Now we have some more news from the NHL, this time concerning the New Jersey Devils. Now this news did break yesterday. It's the first chance I've had to sit down and discuss it here in a video, but Ray Shiro is out as the GM of the New Jersey Devils. Now when the information was first put out to the public, it was basically indicated that it was a parting of ways between the Devils and Ray Shiro. Since then I have seen several reports indicating that he was fired, so I think it's fair to say that the Devils have fired Ray Shiro here, that they just didn't come to an agreement to depart ways. Now, it wasn't all that long ago that Ray Shiro fired the head coach, John Hines, in New Jersey. Assistant coach Alan Nasruddin was promoted to interim head coach. We've recently seen a big trade of Taylor Hall. This team has certainly underperformed this year, did not hit expectations, and the reshaping of the franchise had begun once again. Now, Ray Shiro, I thought, for the most part, at least on paper, looked like he had done a reasonably really solid job during his tenure of GM with the Devils. When he took over, they were in pretty rough shape, coming off a 7th place finish in the Metro Division. Of course, they've been blessed with 2 first overall draft picks during his tenure there, where they were able to land Nico Hischier and now Jack Hughes. Of course, one of his first big moves was to bring home Kyle Palmieri. He also acquired Taylor Hall, signed Will Butcher, brought in Sammy Vatanen on a trade with the Anaheim Ducks, signed Wayne Simmonds as a free agent this summer, acquired PK Subban, who has not lived up to expectations, but still, you know, a lot of these moves certainly looked pretty good. He also brought in Nikita Gusev in a trade from the Vegas Golden Knights. A lot of these moves are moves that I applauded and thought were great moves to make the team better. But of course, as we can see now, a lot of these moves just haven't panned out. Now, of course, since then, Taylor Hall's been traded away from New Jersey down to the Arizona Coyotes. And the future certainly has a lot of question marks for sure. I mean, goaltending has been an issue for this team, and that has been a big part of the problem in New Jersey, with Corey Schneider's really lost his ability to be the starter. Mackenzie Blackwood is a young up-and-coming goaltender, and he very well might still have a solid NHL career, but certainly a lot of the time it didn't really look like he was capable of taking over the starting job. Of course, they had Keith Kincaid for a stretch of time in there as well. And he certainly had his ups and downs. There were times when he played well as a stretch, but overall, really wasn't the guy to take over and be that number one guy in the net either. So goaltending, I really think, is the main issue with New Jersey for the most part. A lot of the other moves were decent. Like I said, unfortunately, they haven't all worked out. Now, Tom Fitzgerald will take over as interim general manager. Now, of course, he's also been playing some other roles this year. At one point, before John Hines was fired, earlier in the season, he was down on the bench, kind of seeing what was going on. Basically, what appeared to be like more of an investigative role. He's been an assistant GM for some time, has been highly regarded as an up-and-coming potential GM candidate. He's certainly been in contention for other GM jobs around the NHL, and many believed he would be a GM at some point here in the future. You know, from his own quote, he was saying that this is not the way he envisioned it happening, and certainly was caught off guard by the Ray Shiro firing for sure. Now, there was certainly an odd scenario here. A couple things that I just found weird is this happened after a win. They were getting ready to play on game day. This happened about 90 minutes before they were set to take the ice. You know, that was certainly an odd scenario. The owner then has a press conference down by the locker room to announce what's going on. And it just really seemed kind of oddly timed, in my opinion. It's just not something you see very often. More often than not, GMs are sometimes fired during the season, but the more common thing to do is to wait till the end of the year, clean house, start fresh, and get everybody, you know, a new staff in place ready to go before the draft and free agency hits. That's usually how things go. Just a more common way. It doesn't mean that this is a bad move per se. Ray Shiro overall, though, I do think during his time, between his time in Pittsburgh and New Jersey, for the most part, has been a pretty decent general manager. Wouldn't be shocking to see him get another opportunity someday with another NHL club as well. He'll certainly land somewheres with his longtime NHL history. Certainly a lot of moves here for New Jersey. They're certainly a team in turmoil. Now they have an interim general manager and an interim head coach. We'll see if the Devils' luck continues in the draft lottery and if they can move up a substantial amount. You know, clearly to having 2 first overall picks here recently, you would think would have this team further along, but they're just not quite there. And so a lot of these moves, even though they look good at the time, just haven't panned out. During the press conference when they announced that Ray Shearer was no longer the GM of the Devils, the owner did indicate that they were committed to Alan Nasruddin. So I don't think he's going anywhere anytime soon, but I guess they're probably going to wait and let the GM make that long-term decision would be my guess. That's usually how it goes. So I think first things first is they need to give Tom Fitzgerald an opportunity here to get his feet wet as GM, probably right out the rest of the season, and then let him decide if he's the right coach or if they need to go in another direction. Now, apparently, Hall of Fame goaltender, longtime Devil, Marty Brodeur, is going to be having a different role with the organization and assisting Fitzgerald as well, moving more into the hockey operations role. So I guess we'll see how he makes out. I know many have pegged him as potentially being a future GM as well at some point in time. For me, this was a fairly surprising move. I'd like to know what your reactions are. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments. Will Tom Fitzgerald end up being the permanent GM for the Devils moving forward? Or do you see this franchise going in a whole new direction when it comes to the coaching staff and management during the offseason? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments and we'll continue the conversation. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and turning on your notifications so you don't miss any future content. And give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it as well. I'd appreciate it if you did. As always, thank you for watching and I will catch you next time.